Hello, fellow weirdos. We're still playing Cradle, and I have been placed inside another one of these dystopian arcades. And I think I'm gonna plan and plot a little bit here. Instead of building a platform up there, I'm gonna build myself a solid floor and then go back up and try this. Oh, and like before, I'm gonna keep this a separate episode so that I will have to suffer alone. You don't have to watch it unless you choose so. Okay, so these cube showers seem to be independent of the boogie monsters that comes here. It seems that all the cubes that are loose will be thrown around like this, but this just happens periodically. Some upper levels left. No. Yeah, put it there. Because in this level or in this pavilion, the red monster seems to be crumbling all the blocks, but it's not gonna show up until I have actually started earning points. Excuse me for a second. So the recording is working, never mind. Yeah, no gaps. By the way, even though I deeply dislike these cube arcade-y thingies, I wouldn't say that they are badly made. Like, I think they're well made, I just don't like them. As in, the devs have done an okay job, and in a way they even make sense in world, although I think not every player feels the same. But I kind of see the point. I see how they fit in this experimental environment of the flower dome. Wait, what? I didn't do that. Oh no! Let's go down here. I don't want him to burst any of my shiny. Yeah, now I lost that cube. Fuck. I didn't even want to earn that one yet. I just wanted to build. Yes, let's build some more. Build and reveal all the grey blocks that I can exploit. Yes, as I was saying, the design of these cube games, like the sort of in arcade atmosphere and all that, that is that's actually spot on. I even suspect that maybe they are made to be hated, like in universe. To make sure that some of the lower levels are pretty solid. No! Before I start doing anything in the upper levels. Okay. And this is why I don't like floor gaps, because I will fall to the very bottom. Okay, so this bombardment knocks pieces out from everywhere. Gotcha. Yeah, the previous arcade was a slower game than this one seems to be. Requiring some speed again, like once you start collecting the yellows. Let's put them back. No. I want to put this down here. Yeah. Okay. Doesn't knock everything down. Okay, the floor is pretty much fucked, I would say. Oh, okay, it's the bombardment. Gotcha. Oh well. No. Any grays anywhere, pretty please? Destroy these. I just realized there's another strategy possible, is that when you make sure that that all the wanted cubes now the gray one flew away. If you make sure that all the wanted cubes are sort of set in place, or like they are loose on a higher level, and then you wait for you lodge them loose and then wait for a bombardment. I think that might work so that you will get like a bulk of them. Me, bro. I'm gonna create a lot of loose cubes. See if they will make it up there. Oh, and I lost them all. Well, fuck. But still, how do I fucking fail the game? That's the mystery. Kill me. Aha! No, wait. I didn't get killed, did I? Oh, okay. Yeah, let's run out of cubes. I really, 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 really don't feel like doing this. I'll just zen out. Destroy them. Yes, finally. Yes, please skip. Changed again. Wait a minute, game. I wanna take a break. Okay, so now that I have finally learned how to trigger the loss. So basically, I have to use up all the cubes. That's the loose condition. And now I will end this fiasco of an episode here, and we'll start a new one for some proper play. If you watched, well, tough luck. I'll see you in the next one. Bye!